There were three planets in our solar system's Goldilocks zone. Those three planets are Venus, Mars, and Earth. Venus is too close to Sun, and its atmosphere is full of carbon dioxide and the sulfur. So the life is nearly impossible on the surface of Venus. And the Mars glides too far, and it do not have any substantial atmosphere to support the life on the planet. Only Goldilocks zone planet is Earth, where the life exists because it has a proper atmosphere which protects the life from the sun's harmful rays. It protects the Earth from the sun's ultraviolet ray, from the sun's flames. That is why the life thrives over here in Earth. Different kind of lives thrived over here on Earth. The definitions of the Goldilocks zone is an habitable zone around the star where it is not too hot and not too cold for the liquid water to exist on the surface of surrounding planets. Hello everyone, welcome to the Power Academy. Our today's focus is on Mars, because the Mars is an excellent planet where the life could survive after Earth. That's why NASA spends billions of dollars to send its Curiosity and the Perseverance rover to explore the Mars soil, atmosphere and the other things. The India also sent a Mars observatory satellite by spending only $75 million, and India became the first country to successfully send its orbiter in the first attempt. So India is a successful country in sending the orbiter on the Mars orbit. And why the Mars is in the news now? Recently, the Indian scientists at the Physical Research Laboratory in Ahmedabad have spotted the thousands of tracks on the surface created by tumbling boulders. The boulders' tracks can be used to pinpoint the recent seismic activity on the planet as the human become more and the more interested in the red planet to develop the colonies in the near future. Because we have almost kill our Earth by polluting it, we make it a gas chamber. So that is why recently the SpaceX founder, the Elon Musk, gave an idea how to colonize the Mars. His idea is basically related to the nuking the Mars. But the nuking the Mars won't make it an habitable place. It would make it a more barren and the more polluted place on the universe, planetary systems. So he has to come up with a better plan and the better budgetary systems that will going to support his plan. Then what are the movements as found recently on the Mars? The study published last month in the Geophysics Research Letters states that it takes about a 4 Martian years, which is equivalent to the 4 to 8 Earth years, for those boulder tracks to disappear, whereas on the Earth, they are rarely preserved because of the constant atmospheric activity. These ejections and the tracks can be used to recognize the very recent surface process on the planetary surface. When a boulder falls at the each bounce, the regolith means the surface material. In case of the Mars, the Martian soils and the stones. So the regoliths on the surface is thrown out in a unique pattern. On Mars, these patterns appear V-shaped with the spread pointing downslope, and the spacing between each bounce is non-uniform. The spatial spread from bounce to bounce and the boulder to boulder. The herringbone-like patterns of the tracks on the surface are formed by bouncing boulders, and 4,500 such tracks have been spotted nearly 900 km length of surface. Nearly 30% of these ejections are observed in the Cerberus Fossae regions, which suggested it is one of the most seismically active regions on Mars. The researchers glanced over thousands of images captured from 2006 through 2020 by the high-resolution imaging scientific experiment camera on board the NASA's Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter. They found more unique tracks all over the Mars, indicating the recent activity on the planet. So from these movements, the scientists had came to a conclusion that the Mars is an active planet, is an alive planet. The NASA sends curiosity, perseverance, and the opportunity to search for the past life that indicates the autotrophic, chemotrophic microorganism as well as the ancient water, including the fluvio lacustrine environments, planets related to the ancient rivers or the lakes that may have been habitable. The findings of the organic compounds inside sedimentary rocks and the boron on the Mars are of interest as they are precursors for the prebiotic chemistry. Such findings, along with the previous discoveries that the liquid water was clearly present in ancient Mars, further supports the possible early habitation by habitability of the Gallic craters on Mars. Currently, the surface of the Mars is bathed with ionizing radiations, and the Martian soil is rich in the particulates toxic to the organisms. From those evidences, the scientists are coming to the conclusion that the Mars is an active planet. Recently, from the regolith movement, the Indian scientists also came to the conclusion that the Mars is an active planet. As we all know, Mars is a barren land without possibility of the human habitations. One of the main reason is water, another is atmosphere, other is gravity. Because to thrive the life, the water is a very important source. The water is needed for the human beings. Without water, the human cannot survive. And also the atmosphere. Mars do not have any atmosphere. So how the Mars atmosphere will going to protect the human beings from the ultraviolet ray? Because ultraviolet, X-ray, and the different kind of rays which emits from the sun, which is very, very harmful for the human body. So it is nearly impossible for the human beings to live on the Mars freely, at least for these times. So and the gravity. And the gravity is lesser than the Earth. So the human beings have to adjust with the gravity of the Mars. That is a very tough task, because to cope up with the gravity, the scientist and the space workers actually practice over the years and the years to do maneuver with the gravity. But the natural human beings, those who are very normal spending the life on Earth, if they will be sent on the Mars, they will have a massive problems. Maybe they will die on the surface of the Mars. But the scientists are seeking the solutions how to make it an habitable place. Solutions is pretty tough looking, but the scientists will try their best. And some of the solutions have came from the private citizens, and they came from some scientists, those who are outside, those who are not working with the NASA or the ISRO. They are also giving their ideas, their opinion that the how to make the Mars an habitable place. Hopefully, when the humans will start living there on the Mars, hopefully they will not going to make the Mars as a gas chamber as they make the Earth. That is why we are looking for an alternative. Our current alternative is only Mars, because we cannot send the human beings to the billions of kilometers away from us, because we do not have that kind of technology. And we have actually not came up with a technology that the what are the things over there in the exoplanets. So we cannot send the human beings is the first thing, and we do not have a technology to see into those exoplanets directly. We are just guessing, hunching the things on the basis of the scientific calculations, whatever the calculations are here on Earth. So it is nearly impossible for the human beings to leave the Earth and the live on any planet on the solar system and any planet on the other solar systems. So we are only left up with an Earth, but the Mars is a solution that the human beings will make it and possible to leave the human beings over there on the Mars with an basic scientific solutions. So we have reached our question part, and our today's question is, identify the planet whose length of days and the tilt of its axis are almost identical to those of the Earth. The first is Uranus, second is Neptune, third is Saturn, fourth is Mars. Second question is, which of the following planets of the solar system has the longest day? First is Mercury, second is Jupiter, third is Venus, fourth is Earth. If any one of you have any doubt about this topic or about any topics I have already discussed, then you can mail me to my email address, which is twin.power.academy@gmail.com. Thank you very much. Thank you for your attention.